She is one of India's most iconic women. She is highly respected, revered, and is a role model for Indians world over. As chairperson of the Infosys Foundation, the work that Mrs. Sudha Murthy has been doing since 1996 is both epic and mammoth. As we catch up with her at the Infosys campus in Bangalore, I'm Neva Jain here. Welcome to Zee Business and welcome to The Big Idea. Never worry about numbers. Help one person at a time and start the person nearest to you, as quoted by Mother Teresa, which truly describes Sudha Murthy, our very own Mother Teresa. Namaste.
Namaste,
Mrs. Murthy, wonderful to have you on The Big Idea and in Infosys campus, no less. Thank you, Ji. Acha, as I said in the opening, Mrs. Murthy, you are truly one of India's ultimate role models. What you have done, what you have achieved in your life, I actually want to discuss that, from the Padma Shri to the author of how many books, to a columnist in Kannada and English, to the Padma Shri, to being a professor. Is there anything left?
I don't know.
Anything baki to achieve?
I don't know. Whatever role I get, I think I will do it very well with the passion.
Yeah.
That's all I know.
You really feel that way? It's just about the passion?
Yeah. Because ultimately, I enjoy my work.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
I tell, every day is a holiday to me. I don't have to take any holiday because I enjoy my work so much.
Wow.
In all the days I work. And
how many days a week do you work, Mrs.
Murthy? All 7 days, actually.
You do?
Yeah. And I travel about 22 days in a month.
For the foundation?
Foundation. Only for foundation I do. Rarely about, you know, that is my identity, actually.
It is your identity, isn't it? It is indeed. Mrs. Murthy, when you started in 1997, could you possibly imagine, as chairperson of the Infosys Foundation, that you would reach the level you would reach, do the type of work that you're doing, so meaningful?
We started in 1996, December.
Yes.
Started
yes.
working effectively in 1997.
Okay.
That time the funding was also very small.
Uh-huh.
And normally I don't imagine a lot and, you know, try to reach that. Even when we started Infosys, Narayan Murthy and his friends, I felt we started a company. Not more than that, okay, it will reach to this, we have to reach this, we have to earn this, nothing of that. So I don't keep a goal to reach that.
Oh, you weren't on that kind of mindset?
That is not my mindset. My mindset is, given a set of circumstances,
okay,
what you can do, you are
the best out of it. How do you leverage the best out of it?
Yeah, yeah. So that I go on doing everywhere, every time in my life.
Amazing. That's very unusual. Very different logic. So
because you won't be disappointed that.
Now you're
and
explaining.
Ultimate happiness is keeping your expectation bar very high, and in case you know, and expecting too much from people, from society, from everyone, and if you are not able to meet, then you'll be
then
unhappy.
You feel unhappy.
So just do your work passionately. Where it takes.
That is very profound, Mrs. Murthy, and very true. So when you started in 1997, what were the initial hurdles you faced, and what did you want to achieve in terms of the foundation work?
Actually, we started foundation with 32 lakhs, 16 lakhs one quarter, 32 lakhs or something.
Okay.
And we did not know where to spend, though I had a rough idea. So we decided to spend on education. I'm very, very keen on that, even now.
Yes.
Health. Then rural. I grew up in a village, I knew what it is.
Uh-huh.
And art and culture.
Okay. So that was the order of preference.
Preferences. Ultimately, preference is circumstances. Okay?
Well,
suppose that there is a patient and there is an art, then I rather go to a patient.
To the patient.
If there is a performing art and there is something else, then I go for a performing art, depending on the situation. So, that's the way we started and slowly went on building. And initially, you know, I used to think everybody should work the way I work. But I realized that is not true. And the people whom we help at times, they don't respect. Sometimes people talk at your back. Sometimes people make comments. In social work, the main quality is you should not expect any return for your work. Even though you help people, people may not even appreciate that.
Oh, you feel that way in social
work? Yeah, oh, that's a lot. And people like to cheat at times. You know, it may not be often, but sometimes. But you should know your way of finding it out. Follow up. Ultimately, you should love fellow human beings. Philanthropy in Latin means love, phil means fellow. So love fellow human beings. You should have that. And then you enjoy your work.
So true. Did you always dream of entering the domain of philanthropy to the level you have done?
No. I grew up in a village with my grandparents.
Share with us.
I have written about those experiences books also.
Yes.
The giving away a part of our wealth was always a part of our culture in the family.
The DNA of your family.
Always,
culture.
Always. We are not rich people, you know, not very rich people, moderately rich. But whatever we have, in that you should be given. Like I wrote an article, a red rice granary. We used to have, my grandfather had paddy fields and we used to have granary. Okay. A good rice and an ordinary rice.
Okay.
And in the evening, every day, they will cook ordinary rice for us.
Okay.
But if anyone comes in the village asking for help, we will give always a good rice to them. So I asked my grandmother and grandfather, why should we give always good rice to someone and eat an ordinary rice, actually a red rice that was.
Yeah.
In those days, the red rice did not have much meaning. Today it has become high, you know, very important.
Yes, brown rice.
She told me in a very simple way, she never went to school, my grandmother, but she told me, God comes to your house in a different form as a beggar, as a helpless people or whatever it is. What do you give the best whenever God comes to your house? I said, I'll give the best to him, then I'll give the good rice. But my grandfather quoted the Daitarya Upanishad and told, yes, there is a way to live in life. There are 33 stanzas we are given in Upanishad. One of them is Danam Priyavak Sahitam, Shraddha Hidanam, Ashraddha Hinadanam. When you want to give with a good heart, with the tongue and the mind and the heart, okay? Give with a good intention. Give without expectations.
Beautiful. Oh, Mrs. Murthy, and that's how you define your life.
Yeah.